Welcome to CBS Sports coverage of the NCAA tournament. Today's game is between the St. Louis Billikens and the Kentucky Wildcats. Ladies and gentlemen, the bracket. There's a look at the starting lineup.
Check out the small forwards. I think these kids are great to watch. These guys deserve to be in the starting lineup because of what they bring to the table.
And let's have a look at the keys to the game for these teams here today.
If they can get these things accomplished, they're going to have a good shot at the win today.
The Billikens get possession, and away we go. On the right side. Fires. No. Pulls down the rebound. The Wildcats look to work the dribble drive.
Now they have guys who can dribble penetrate. It's tough to guard because you have to help out on the defense, defend the drive, and leaves guys open from deep.
But he misses his target. They've worked the perimeter. Shots up. Shots off. Takes the board. Pushes it. He missed it. Rips it down. Thanks for joining CBS Sports coverage of NCAA basketball. I'm Gus Johnson alongside Bill Raftery. Weaver handles the pass. He shoots from the corner. And hits. He can put up points and he can move the ball.
You know he's a real talent. He can set up his teammates for open looks and really has a nose for the goal.
On the outside. Shots off.
I own it.
Goodwin receives the pass. Jump shot. And he can't get the bounce. Grabs the rebound. Around 8 minutes remaining. Whitney handles the feed. Fires. And yet another missed field goal attempt, coach. They're struggling.
I don't think any of them are concentrating right now.
Receives the ball. And they get the turnover. On the right side. He can't get it to go.
Look to outlet.
On the wing. Jump shot.
Squared up on the catch. Got his puppies in order.
7 minutes left on the game clock. On the right side. He shoots from the corner.
Got it. Wow.
Look at them swing the ball.
That's how it's meant to be done. It's so important that the ball moves from one side of the court to the other. Stretch the D and then attack.
On the right side, with 10 to shoot now. In the lane, shots off. They work the perimeter. He tries the three. No luck from downtown.
Oh, physicality.
6 minutes left on the game clock. They work it around the perimeter. He strokes it. Off the mark. Grabs the rebound. Out on the right wing. Dials up a long-range shot. And no! On the low block. Shots off. Pulls it in.
How about that elevation?
He cut back door. The pass was delivered.
Gus, as a coach, you teach your players to read the defense in order to make that type of pass. What's great about it is that it ended with a basket.
Let's go back and look at this one again.
He's looking good. Strong to the goal. Send it in.
How about the action so far, Coach? Some good postseason tournament action. I'm certain the people watching are enjoying this one. Neither team backing down at this point.
I'll tell you what makes the NCAA so special is the fact that it takes one bad night. One bad night, and your season is over. It's going to be a shame that when the final horn sounds, one of these very competitive teams will be out. Season will be over.
Way out on the right wing. Fires. Coach, these guys are really struggling here tonight.
Having a tough time finding the goal. Not a great performance here tonight, Gus.
Both teams are looking to get some... Look, and the block. That finds its way out of bounds, but we'll keep it right here. Baseline inbound. He looks for three. He hits it from way downtown. On the wing. We're at the 4 minute mark on the left side. Lobs it. Up and in. Ha ha! Cross court. He unloads the three and misses. Dump it inside. And the ball is out of bounds. We'll go back the other way. It's a team effort across the board so far today, Coach.
Gus, it makes things really difficult for the defense when multiple players are contributing at the offensive end. I doubt they were prepared for this.
They may have him in some trouble here, Rat.
What a great trap, Gus. The defense is getting after it.
Jump shot. The sophomore. We're at the 3 minute mark. It's knocked out of there. Blocked. And we'll get a change of possession. Baseline inbound. Ball handler may be in a bit of trouble, Rath. Out on the wing. He takes the three. He misses from the outside. On the right side. We are at the 2 minute mark. And he hits it. dump it inside. Call for the foul. See, we'll press him on defense here. He winds up with the foul.
Now, you always get the hand reaching in and get in trouble.
Here we have a look at one of the sophomores for this team.
Gus, he's young, but he's been through his freshman year, and he's learned a lot. This is going to be another big season for him. Let's see how he does today.
Makes it. Pushes it. Ball handler may be in a bit of trouble, Raph. Nice job defensively. It's our call for the foul. Obviously too aggressive here defensively.
You've really got to know your limitations, Gus.
To the line. Makes the foul shot. Gets two at the charity stripe. A great trap initiated by the defense. May have him right where they want him, Raph. Oh, now that's poor offensive execution.
10-second violation. Oh, that's a tough one to handle.
On the right side. The freshman commits the turnover. Brooks on the move. The Wildcats running their zone offense.
Very effective because of the power on the glass. It opens up that opportunity for tips.
The Billikens motion for around one.
Understanding what type of shot you want is essential in this offense.
Out on the left wing. Fires. No.
Get out and fill.
Stolen away. On the left side. Jump shot. He missed it. Snags the offensive rebound. Shots off. Way out on the right wing. And he can't get it. Nice rejection. Out of bounds, and we're not going anywhere. They'll start from the baseline. Heat check time from long range.
Oh!
With time running out, he can't get it to go. The first half is in the books. The road to the Final Four is up next. And let's take a moment to look at some team stats for both sides here. Let's check in and take a look at how both sides are doing with the keys to the game. Second half of play, coach, NCAA tournament. Doesn't get much bigger than this. Who's going to fight to ensure that they move on to the next round? The answer, just a moment.
One thing that separates who can march on and win six in a row from those who can't is the ability to handle pressure. The ability to play with poise and be able to finish games is extremely important.
French handles the feed. Shot clock shows 10. Let's it go! They're having a tough time hitting from the floor. Both teams looking to get in a bit of a rhythm here. Turnover, they'll go the other way. Pushing in transition. On the left side. He shoots from downtown with no luck.
Oh, what a good rebound there, Gus. You got to secure those ones. The more rebounds you get, obviously, the better.
Weaver handles the pass. Taken away. Careless mistake there. On the wing. He fires from long range. Misses from the outside. You know, Raph, this guy has really elevated his game today.
He's in his zone right now, making good decisions and being strong with the ball. Coach has got to be pleased with his performance thus far.
Eight minutes left on the game clock. Richards with the ball. Fires. Off the mark with the shot. Looking for a good shot. Off the mark. He drains the bucket. This guy is really known as a power guy.
When he gets it down deep on the box, this kid can knock it down.
Now they work it around the perimeter. He lets it go, and he misses the shot. Out on the left wing. We are at the 7-minute mark. French handles the feed. Jump shot. Drains it. Richards gets the ball. He shoots from the corner. Outside, Jay won't go.
It's all about shot selection, Gus. It's so important to take good shots. And not necessarily the shot the defense wants you to take.
On the left side.
Magnificent.
On the inside. Watch out. Bam. We are at the 6-minute mark. Out on the right wing. In the lane. No, takes the board. On the wing. He throws it up from downtown. Not this time. Weaver handles the feed. In the lane. He doesn't get the hoop. On the right side. He fires it up. He can't get the bucket to fall. We're at the 5-minute mark. receiver handles the pass. In the lane. No!
Give me that.
Out on the wing. It won't fall. Goodwin receives the ball. On the right side. He goes for three. And he answered. 4 minutes left on the game clock. Wrap everything we could ask for. Close game in the first half. Still close here in the second half. What a bowl.
Hey, Gus, I think this is going right to the finish line. I think this game may come down to the last possession. These teams are competing and executing to a very high level. I mean, they're making every big shot, both of these clubs.
Top of the key. Second team foul.
The big fella scores it, and he's fouled. So an and-one opportunity here.
Lazy D taking advantage of.
Montgomery is usually automatic when he steps to the line. Foul shot, no good. Weaver receives the pass. Fires. Can't get it to go. On the right side. Minutes left on the game clock. And he's fouled. Obviously too aggressive here defensively.
You really got to know your limitations, Gus. Opportunity here to put some points up, Gus, with the clock stopping.
It's stolen. The Wildcats in a hurry. He shoots from the elbow. He gets the shot to fall. Now they work it around the perimeter. Rejected. Out on the right wing. Jump shot. No! What a rebound. 2 minutes left on the game clock. On the wing. And we'll get a change of possession. The Wildcats are playing great team basketball right now.
Yes, it makes things really difficult for the defense when multiple players are contributing at the offensive end. I doubt they were prepared for this.
They set it up from the baseline. Ball's going to stay down here. Inbound from the baseline. Can't put it down. The Wildcats now running a zone offense.
The impact very similar to their man-to-man. They find the open guy.
On the left side. He puts up the trick. He misses from long range. The Billikens now running the four around one.
Must be alert on that defensive end because guys get pinned and they can step out and knock down the deep one.
Fired! No. Whitney on the left side. He throws up the shot. What do you think, Coach?
You and I both know they need a timeout here, Gus.
We are at the one-minute mark. Goodwin with the ball. And lays it in. A great finish on that backdoor feed.
Oh, what an explosive cut to the tin and just a terrific feed. What a finish, Gus. Some people dread this part of the game, Gus, when the losing team is fouling in order to stop the clock.
And yet another stoppage, and yet another foul.
And why not?
Call for the foul. And, of course, another foul as they try to remain close.
Much else they can do.
Here's another solid junior build.
Juniors and seniors are such important pieces of any college team. Having experienced kids like him, it can really help coaches and reinforce team philosophy.
It's good! Makes the foul shot. The ball handler is in trouble. Tries to get around the trap, but he can't do it.
The young guy has some trouble with that trap.
He lets it go. The shot won't fall. On the right side. From long distance, and he can't hit the shot. We've said it so many times, survive and advance. Well, one survived and will advance. The other one's going home.
Well, when you take a close look at this victory, it came down to execution. We say it all the time, but these guys did a terrific job of getting stops at the defensive end and scores at the offensive end.
That's our coverage of NCAA basketball on CBS Sports. I'm Gus Johnson for Bill Raftery saying good night, and we'll see you next time.